Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me if I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe. Say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. That the wait is over, and love has finally shown her mind.
May my hands be the hands you hold on to when you let go of everything else. And may my arms be the arms that you fall into when the night gets too heavy to hold by yourself. If you're looking for a safer place to land, I will guide you home. And if the levee of your life breaks all your plans, you'll never be alone. If you dance with me, feel my heart beat through body to your feet. If you dare.
Welcome, family and friends. It is such a wonderful feeling to be here to celebrate the joining of Kristen and Justin in marriage. Today's gathering was planned to be a particularly intimate one, with each one of you invited because of the special place that you hold in Kristen and Justin's hearts and lives. For Kristen and Justin, this ceremony is not about pomp, but about being married, and marriage in the large sense has always spoken about family and community. It is with you that they have shared the most important moments and relations of their lives. Born or chosen, you are those they call family, and those whom they have loved most in the world. Who gives this woman to be married today?
Her mother and I.
This place that Kristen and Justin have chosen for their wedding day is ripe with so many wonderful and appropriate metaphors. It is a place of peace and renewal amid the activity of the busy city. Can you think of a better analogy for a good marriage? The security and trust that their love provides is the firmest of all foundations from which to move forward into making their dreams a reality. Nature has always inspired a connection to something larger than ourselves. In marriage, we gladly accept that love is the greatest thing in our lives, and that through surrendering to it, we ourselves are become infinite and limitless. Today we speak in terms of ideals. However, this ceremony also needs to have a practical side that speaks of how, as the years pass, Kristen and Justin shall remain close to one another in spirit. It is with this in mind that I will begin by asking you to make your promises together. Do you promise to one another your openness and honesty, that your love for one another shall be in the foreground of your thoughts always, guiding your actions, and that you will leave no parts of self unknowable to one another?
We do.
Do you pledge to continue to love one another wholly and fearlessly, that you will share in each other's laughter and work together to spark creativity and inspire passion in all aspects of your life together.
We do.
Do you promise that you will always be there to comfort, soothe, and heal one another, that you will stand together when the future is unclear, proving that times may change, but your love is constant?
We do.
Do you promise that your home will always be a place of warmth and welcome, a safe haven and sanctuary to body, mind, and spirit, that shall sustain and nourish your roots as you grow into all that is and shall continue to be your life together?
We do.
Living by these promises that you make today, may your lives together be blessed with love and laughter, wisdom and wonder. The Lord be with you. Looking at the guests, let us pray. Gracious Father and ever-living God, our hearts are filled with great happiness on this, the wedding of Kristen and Justin. They have come before you, pledging their lives and their hearts to one another, living together in a way that shall ever nurture the soul of their marriage. Temper their hearts with kindness and help them to be sweethearts, helpmates, friend, and guide, so that together may they meet the cares and problems of life more bravely. May their home truly be a place of love and harmony where your spirit is ever present. Bless their wedding day, we pray, and walk beside them through all their life together. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Chris, would you come forward? Chris and I will now read from the Gospel of Paul, taken from 1 Corinthians. You want to read just off mine?
Yeah. Speak right into the microphone. God is love.
May you have his kind of love for each other.
Love is patient and kind.
May you be able to lovingly overlook each other's faults and weaknesses.
Love is not jealous or boastful.
May you seek praise for each other and not for yourselves.
Love is not arrogant or rude.
May you give of yourselves for each other's needs and treat one another with utmost respect.
Love does not insist on its own way.
May you genuinely listen to each other with a willingness to be wrong yourselves.
Love is not irritable or resentful.
May you be tolerant of each other's moods, always ready to forgive, never holding a grudge.
Love does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right.
May you experience happiness because of each other's triumphs and successes.
Love bears all things.
May you seek to understand each other's differences, knowing you will stick together through it all.
Love hopes all things.
May you always expect the best in each situation, regardless of temporary setbacks.
Love never ends.
May you spend the rest of your lives together enjoying God's love.
Thank you. It is said that we learn how to give and receive love through the act of being loved. The first and strongest love we feel is that of our parents as they love and nurture us into adulthood and beyond. Throughout this ceremony, Kristen and Justin's parents have been holding their rings for them as a sign of their blessing upon this marriage and a promise of their continued love and support. Will the mothers of the bride and groom please bring the rings forward? Okay, ladies, hold your rings out. Let your hands below serve as a reminder of how Kristen and Justin and their marriage are supported upon the earth by the love of family and friends, as well as blessed from above. Take those rings. Don't go anywhere. Holy Spirit, guardian of all that is seen and unseen, bless these rings and the couple who shall wear them. Keep them safe through adversity forever, supported by your eternal blessing. Amen. Mothers, kiss their child and return to their seats. It is a beautiful and appropriate tribute that their last kiss as single people should come from the two women who gave them their first kiss and breath into this life, their mothers. Let us pray. O God, may these rings forever signify the love of these two. As these circles are fashioned without an ending, they speak of eternity. May the incorruptible substance of these rings represent a love glowing with increasing luster through the years. Amen. All right, Justin, you ready? All right. Justin, do you take Kristen to be your wife?
I do.
Will you now place the ring on Kristen's finger and repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In friendship, loyalty, and love.
In friendship, loyalty, and love.
I promise to walk neither in front of nor behind.
I promise to walk neither in front of you nor behind.
But beside you.
Beside you.
And to love you always.
And to love you always.
As we advance through the cycles of life.
As we advance through the cycles of life.
I promise to grow with you and not away from you.
I promise to grow with you and not away from you.
I pledge to you that as this ring encircles your finger.
I pledge to you as this ring encircles your finger.
So shall my love forever embrace you.
So shall my love and embrace you forever.
Whenever you look at this ring, remember.
Whenever you look at this ring, remember
that my promise is eternal.
That my promise is eternal.
And that I shall love you always.
And that I shall love you always.
Kristen, do you take Justin to be your husband?
Yeah, I do.
Will you now place the ring on Justin's finger and repeat after me? This ring I give you in friendship.
This ring I give you in friendship.
Loyalty and love.
Loyalty and love.
I promise to walk neither in front of.
I promise to walk neither in front of.
Nor behind.
Nor behind.
But beside you.
But beside you.
And to love you always.
And to love you always.
As we advance through the cycles of life.
As we advance through the cycles of life.
I promise to grow with you.
I promise to grow with you.
And not away from you.
And not away from you.
I pledge to you.
I pledge to you.
That as this ring encircles your finger.
As this ring encircles your finger.
So shall my love forever embrace you.
So shall my love ever embrace you.
Whenever you look at this ring.
Whenever you look at this ring.
Remember that my promise is eternal.
Remember that my promise is eternal.
And that I shall love you always.
And that I shall love you always.
Kristen and Justin have included the sand ceremony in this service, and we're going to move over here. We're going to pull this over here. Kristen and Justin, today we are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other and honor your child as well. Family relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these individual containers of sand, each representing all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. And there's a third container for Neytiri. There is a child who will share in this marriage. Neytiri will help us with the blending of the sands. The gathering of this new family will have a deep influence upon them. We realize that in order for the home to be a happy one, it is essential that there be love and understanding between the children and the adults being married. As you each hold your sand, the separate containers of sand represent your lives to this moment, individual and unique. As you now combine your sand together, your lives also join together as one family. Mm-hmm. Blending the sand together symbolizes the uniting of this child and bride and groom into one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage and your family be. Neytiri, you can go sit with Grandma and Grandpa. I'd like you to. It's time, kids. And now that you've made your vows and promises of love and faithfulness before these witnesses and exchanged rings of commitment as a testimony to that love, with the authority vested in me by the state of Florida, it is my honor and privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present Mr. and Mrs. Gillespie. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want.